Hello guys and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this video I will be showing you that how to make an API using Python Flask, and in the next video we will be implementing that API in our Flutter app. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. Step 1. Importing the important libraries that we will be using. Before importing the libraries, you need to install Flask and PyMongo library. And you can install them very easily. If you are using Mac, then you can use the command pip 3 install Flask. It will make sure to install the Flask, and then you can use pip 3 install PyMongo in your terminal and it will install PyMongo. Now if you are using Windows machine, then you can also use pip 3 install Flask and pip 3 install PyMongo, but you can also use pip install PyMongo and pip install Flask. If you have installed both versions of Python in your computer, then you can use pip 3 to make sure that the libraries install in the current version, which is Python 3. After importing the libraries, the first thing will be to initialize Flask library. And we can do that very easily. All you have to do is write Flask, and then you have to pass underscore underscore name underscore underscore. So this will make sure to initialize Flask, and it will assign that to a variable name a. Once Flask is initialized, then we have to initialize our PyMongoDB as well. We need PyMongoDB for storing our data. Like suppose if we want to create new to-do, it will be stored in our PyMongo database. So first of all, we need to make sure that our Python program and MongoDB database is connected. And we can do that very easily. All you have to do is to pass database URI to Mongo client. Basically, database URI is the place where your MongoDB database is located. I will put a link in the description where you will find how to create this link, how to create new MongoDB database. And all you have to do is just replace this link. And now in the next line, you can see here Python todo. Basically, this is the database name. Python todo will be replaced by your database name. Now in this line, DB represent database and here todo represent collection. Now collection is similar to tables in a traditional database. MongoDB is a NoSQL database similar to Firebase. Now here is the main part, and which is how to create new to-do and save that in our MongoDB database. So we will be creating our first root or first API endpoint, and which will be to-dos. Now let me explain what each line does. Now here we have used a decorator app.root, and here we are passing two things. First one is a string which is to-dos. Basically this will be the endpoint. The second thing that we are passing is method, and here we are passing post. By passing post, it's mean that this root will only accept post request. If someone do a get request, it will throw an error. Now if someone make a post request, it will execute the create to-do function. Now the first thing that we will be doing is getting our data, getting our JSON data that the user post via post request, and we can use getJSON function for that. Basically this function is provided by the Flask library, and here we are checking if title or status, either of them is missing. If it is missing, then we are throwing error missing required field with the status code 400. Next you can see that we are preparing data to be saved. And here we are using title, status and description. And in the description we are using .get. And we are using that for one reason. Because description is optional, and if it is not provided in the JSON data that we receive from the user, then we will be using empty string instead of that. Now in the next line we are basically calling collection.insert1. And we are basically passing the todo. Now this line will make sure that our todo is saved in our database. Now we are checking result.insertedID. If insertedID exists, then in that case we will be responding with the inserted ID, and we will let the user know that todo created successfully, and we will be posting that with the status code 201. Now if for some reason we did not get the inserted ID, it's mean that todo is unable to save in database, and in that case we will be throwing error. We will be letting the user know that failed to create todo, and we will be responding with the status code 500. Now we are done with create todo. Now we will be creating a new root, and that will be using to update our todo or existing todo. Now in order to call this, we will need to call example.com/update/id. Now here the id will be passed to the update todo function, and this is passing because in the app.root decorator we are passing update/string todo. This means that whatever come after the update, it will be passed automatically to the update todo function. Now in the update todo function, we are basically calling object id and passing the todo id. Basically it's convert the todo id to object id, and we are using that that in order to update our existing MongoDB record. Now here MongoDB uses ID as an object ID and it does not use a string ID. So that's why we are using that. That's the only reason why we are converting our Todo ID to object ID. And the object ID comes from binary JSON, which is included in the PyMongo library. So we import that and we are using it only for this purpose. Once our ID is converted to object ID, then we are getting our data by request.getJSON, similar to create todo function. And then we are preparing our data. The main difference between create todo and update todo is this line. In the create todo, we basically use collection.insert1, and here we are using update1. And here we are passing the todo ID, and then we are passing the updated data. And here, if you notice, we pass set. So basically, this set means that update the field which exists in update todo. Now after that we are checking if result.modified count is greater than 0. It's mean if the updated documents count is greater than 0, it's mean that the todo is updated successfully. If it is 0, it's mean that either todo is not found or failed to update. In that case, we will be responding with error todo not found, and we will be posting that with the status code 404. Now let's create our third endpoint, which will be todos. When someone make get request to this endpoint, it will execute the function, and in the function we are using collection.find and we are passing empty directory, and then we are converting the result to a list and we are storing that in a local variable todos. Now we have run a loop through our todos, and here we are converting our todo ID to string. Whenever we create new todo object, it's automatically assigned object ID to it, and basically we need to convert that to a string. And here we are doing that, and after that we are converting our data to JSON and returning as a response. Now this next endpoint is very similar to the previous one. The only difference is that we are only getting one todo instead of getting multiple todo. So here again we will be first of all converting the ID to object ID, and then after that we will be using collection.find1, and here we will be also passing the todo object ID. And if todo exists, it's mean that we have found our todo on that ID, and we are basically converting that object ID to a string ID and then basically returning that as a response. Now if we did not find anything, then we will be posting error. We will be responding with error todo not found 404, and if there is something wrong with the todo ID, then we will be responding with other error invalid todo ID, and we will be responding that with 400 status code. Now here is our final endpoint, which is delete. It is similar to the get endpoint, and the only difference here is that we are calling collection.delete1 instead of collection.find1, and after that we have to check if the document is deleted or not, and we can check that using result.deletedCount. If the deleted count is greater than 0, it's mean that the document has been deleted, and we can respond with message todo deleted successfully. And if the deleted count is 0, it's mean that there is no todo in the database against that ID, and we will respond with todo not found 404 status code. Now our API is almost complete. We just need to run our server. Now here we have put a simple check, and after that we are running our server. Now our API is completed, so let's run our Flask app and let's see if it is working or not. We will be testing via Postman, and I will be sharing the Postman collection in my description. Here in the terminal you can see our server URL, and it is running on localhost. In the next video we will be integrating this API in our Flutter app.
I was a lonely silhouette, needed somebody to show the way. Yeah, I was a heartbeat with no sound till you came around. Yeah, you showed me colors, light in the darkness. You were the only thing I needed. Then we got older, but we stayed the same. Swear that we never lost the flame. No.